But let's move on now. We have Godrej Consumer. They reported a decent set of Q2 numbers. We have Vivek Gambhir, the Managing Director and CEO of the company, who joins in now. Mr. Gambhir, hi. Thanks very much for taking the time. Let's start with household insecticides. It was a weak performance, you know, probably due to the Kerala floods, scattered rains, and maybe the increasing trend of maybe higher usage of incense sticks as well. How are you tackling these issues, and what kind of outlook do you have for the rest of the year?
Now, overall, I think as far as the India business is concerned, we've been delivering double-digit growth for multiple quarters now. And what's good about the India business performance is that along with double-digit sales growth, the volume growth's been healthy. Gross margins have been increasing. We've been investing significantly in A&P and also driving profit growth ahead of sales growth with margin expansion. Across categories, household insecticides and soaps and air fresheners had done quite well. But clearly, home insecticides was a soft quarter, largely driven by scattered monsoons, particularly in the east and the west of India, which is almost 60% of our sales. We have launched a slew of new innovations in insecticides. We have launched a Goodnight Power Chip. We've launched a Green Shakti Coil. And we have a couple of other very interesting innovations that we are planning to launch in the next quarter or so. Hopefully on the back of these innovations, and if the season improves, then we should see a much better performance from the insecticides business over the next couple of quarters. Overall, we are very optimistic that the second half of the year should be a stronger performance on both top line and bottom line growth.
Will the run rate in soaps and hair color continue, and what's the outlook for the second half?
For us, I think the expectation clearly is that across the board, soaps, hair colors, air fresheners and insecticides should deliver a stronger performance in the second half of the year. The overall demand environment continues to improve, particularly in rural India. For us in rural India, the uptick was much stronger than in urban India. And as long as the momentum in consumer demand continues, we are hopeful of a stronger performance in the second half of the year.
Would you continue to say report improvement in your EBIT margins in Indonesia?
At an overall level, at a consolidated level, we are confident that our profit growth will be ahead of sales growth, and we will see margin expansion. Quarter over quarter, depending on the kind of innovations that are there, you might see some margin volatility, but for the overall year as a whole, for GCPL, we should see margin expansion.
Okay, your African operations made a loss this quarter. Can you provide us some outlook or guidance for the same?
On the African operations, East Africa has been recovering nicely. West Africa performance was quite strong. The challenge was in our South African operations, which underperformed for a couple of reasons. One is we witnessed some very intense competition from some low-cost players, which were responding with some new product innovations. And second of all, the macroeconomic situation there has been very challenging. Having said that though, we are very optimistic that on both top-line growth and bottom-line growth, the performance in our Africa cluster should be much stronger in the second half of the year.
And volume growth as a whole for the remainder of the second half?
You know, see, for us in the India business, in the first half of the year, the volume growth was about 10%. And so as we look to the second half of the year, our expectation is that we should be able to deliver double-digit volume growth.
Okay, double-digit volume growth. Lastly, your ad spends were up around 20% this quarter. Is it going to continue being 10% of sales? What's your outlook guidance there, if you have any?
Our ad spends typically tend to be between 11 to 12% of sales. We clearly have a lot of exciting innovations that we are launching. Our efforts will be to ensure that we can back these innovations with healthy A&P investment. But clearly, I think the range is what we are comfortable with. And even with this kind of advertising spend, we feel confident that we can deliver sustained profitable growth.
Okay. All right, Mr. Gambhir, we're going to leave it on that note. So thanks very much for joining in. That's the view coming in from Godrej Consumer. The stock a little bit subdued at this point. Just want to check on the markets again. The mid-cap index has in fact extended its losses and is in line in terms of the percentage loss that we're seeing.